With Halloween approaching very fast, we have decided to do something special. We're gonna do a Halloween drone, and in this case, the first in the world. A flying pumpkin drone with lights and scary sound. In case you're up for it, we will only use easy accessible parts that can be purchased through Amazon or through the local hardware store. I'll make sure to leave a link in the description below where you can get the most important parts. Welcome to the channel Drones and Electric Unicycles, where we provide weekly tips, tricks and tutorials to help you get the best out of your equipment. Consider subscribing so you don't miss out on the latest from us. I often get the question why the channel is called Drones and Electric Unicycles, when most of the drone stuff is centered around the DJI Mavic Pro. Before I purchased my Mavic, I was building a lot of RC stuff myself, so I know the ropes. I was especially fascinated with tricopters and quads. I built a lot of those from scrap parts I've picked up around the net. I will be using parts from one of these builds to make the Halloween pumpkin drone, combined with a plastic pumpkin head picked up at a local hardware store. Before we get to the part where we integrate pumpkin lights and sound, we need to build a stable quadcopter platform. To be able to build a quadcopter, we need some essential parts, like 4 motors, 4 propellers, and speed controllers, a flight controller, and an RC link. On top of that, we need a battery to power the drone, an RC transmitter to control it, and a frame to strap it on. This is the basic for any quadcopter. Anything else like GPS and camera is just icing on the cake, but clearly makes the flying experience better, especially for new pilots. If you can complete this build, you have the basic knowledge to do your own stuff. Let's go over the parts we will use. The brain of the Halloween Pumpkin Quad will be the Hobby King KK2 flight controller. This flight controller is pretty cheap and can be configured and trimmed directly in the field through the buttons below the backlit LCD display. We plan to use a brushless motor powered by a speed controller. Without getting too technical, the motor is frequency regulated by the ESC speed controller power supply. The speed of the motor is set through this wire by adjusting the voltage from 0 to 5 volt. You don't need to worry about that, as the Hobby King KK2 flight controller will handle this. The motor is labeled 1350 kV. kV means it runs 1000 RPMs for every 1 volt applied. In our case, we are planning to power the Halloween drone with a 3S LiPo battery, meaning the nominal voltage would be around 11.1. The 3S LiPo has a capacity of 22 milliamp hours. This should give us around 7 to 10 minutes of flight time. Not much, but enough for a good scare. LiPo batteries should never be discharged below 3.1 volt per cell. An easy way to secure that is to add a simple $2 battery alarm that will make a very loud sound when the limit has been reached. Let me throw in a question. Have you ever built your own drone, and what did you find to be the biggest challenge? Share your experience below with the fellow flyers from the Drones and Electric Unicycles community. And remember, the best advice is often found among your comments, so don't be shy. Without propellers, there will be no flying pumpkin. We plan to start out with 8-inch propellers with a 4.5-inch pitch of the blade. Much can be said about selecting the right props for a given setup, but I've built a setup before where this combination has turned out quite successfully. But let's see when we test flight. We can always adjust it from here. There's a tool online that will allow you to calculate the thrust for a given motor and prop combination if you want to go all technical. Link in the description below. In our case, we're looking for something around 1.5 pound thrust per motor, giving us a maximum theoretical thrust of 6 pounds or more. Taking headroom into account, we should aim to keep the weight of the Halloween quad, including everything, below 3 pounds. By the way, a quad needs 2 clockwise and 2 counterclockwise propellers to work. Finally, we have the RC link. For this, we are using a very cheap 6-channel radio and receiver from Hobby King. The receiver goes on the quad and fresh batteries in the radio, so no need to worry more about that part. In all fairness, you need to invest a little time in configuring the radio when it talks to the flight controller. It's not difficult, but you need to be prepared for it. Let's start building the Halloween pumpkin quad. When doing a project like this, the most important part is the frame. This is going to act as the spine of the project. A good frame is light, stable, and dampens vibrations. Vibrations can be pretty harmful and mess with the sensors in the flight controller. As the main component for the frame, we have picked up some aluminum profiles at the local hardware store. They are strong, super light, and perfect for this project. If these are not available, wood will also be a good choice. I also picked up some 5mm MDF plates that will help tie it together and act as a platform for the flight controller. Diagonal cross-cutting the center plate makes the aluminum profiles fit nicely. This also helped reduce vibrations. Matching plates on top and base makes a nice stable construction. They are kept together with threaded screws and bolts. The pumpkin has been prepared by cutting off the top to get easy access to the flight controller later. It can now be mounted on the top of the frame with some wooden screws. Four holes have been added with a soldering iron to allow the speed controller to be mounted easily. Now with the basic construction in place, it's time to install some electrical components. Let's mount the motors and make sure the props clear the pumpkin head. In this case, 1-inch clearance with a 10-inch prop. Now we can cut the arms to the right length. The motors are attached to the arms with double adhesive pads and secured with binders. Next, we install the wiring harness, including the speed controllers. Because the wiring harness is from an old project, it's already connected. The circuit is quite simple, where all the black wires and the red wires are soldered together. We attach the speed controllers the same way we did with the motors. It's a good idea to keep them away from the flight controller, because they are quite noisy and can interfere with it. Connect the bullet connectors for each motor. The battery connection is done by a standard XT60 power connector. With this setup, the speed controller will power the flight controller, so no need for additional power supply. Let's install the flight controller. When I originally bought the controller, it was delivered in a nice black foam box. Using this box makes an ideal vibration-damped platform for the flight controller. The flight controller is kept in position by double adhesive tape to be on the safe side. When placing the flight controller, it's important it points in the right direction and placed as close as possible to the mass center of the drone. With quads, this is quite simple, just go for the cross. When we later install the battery and sound system, we need to make sure not to shift the weight too much. Now it's time to hook up the flight controller. The motor wires need to go out to each channel labeled M1, M2, M3, M4 according to the schematics. The receiver was already connected, but it's pretty straightforward where channel 1 in the receiver is channel 1 on the flight controller and so on. That's it. Let's fire up the Halloween pumpkin drone for the first time. Let's do it. Ha! I know this was not nice keeping you hanging like that. In the next episode, I'm firing up the drone, configuring the flight controller, and install the sound system and make the first test flight. Stay tuned and make sure to hit that bell notification icon below so you get notified when it's online. Take care and see you on the next one.